Today, let's learn how to combine the values from multiple cells into one cell, and also how to split a string to make data more manageable. When we hear people talking about merging cells, they might simply want several cells formatted to look and behave like a single cell. For instance, you may have a heading or title of a data set, and you'd like the title to spread across all the columns of that data set, like this. At other times, merging a cell may mean actually combining the data that's located across several columns or several rows and placing them in a single cell. Let's talk about how to do both. First, how to merge cells by formatting. Method 1 is to use the merge and center command. It's a quick and common way to merge cells by formatting their appearance. Just highlight all the cells to be merged, then click the Merge and Center icon from the Home tab. The problem is some people really don't like this method because if there is data in the cells being merged, Excel will only keep what's in the upper leftmost cell. So if we wanted to merge these two cells, for instance, and we tried to use Merge and Center, we'll get this error message that says merging cells only keeps the upper left value and discards the other values. In other words, you lose any data that isn't in the first cell. Of course, if that's fine, then you'd click OK and you'd lose everything that's not in the first cell. We don't want to do that, so we hit cancel here. And another limitation when you use the Merge and Center option to merge cells is that it prevents you from being able to sort any data that's located in cells which have been merged. Here's an example. So let's see what happens if we try to sort the data in column A. We get an error message that says all the merged cells need to be the same size, which means it can't be sorted. A third issue is that highlighting a column which contains merged cells will result in highlighting all the columns spanning the merged cells, not just the column that was highlighted. So if we want to highlight A2 to A6, we end up highlighting A2 to C6 because A4 to C4 have been merged. This can be a bit annoying. So there is an alternative to Merge and Center. The second method to format cells as a merge is by using the Center Across Selection option by doing the following steps. So let's unmerge these cells, and then we'd select the cells we want to merge, press Ctrl 1 to open the Format Cells dialog box, and in the Alignment tab from the horizontal dropdown, select Center Across Selection. Click OK. And now these cells appear to be merged, but each cell can still be selected one by one, separate from each other. They can also be sorted and highlighted as normal. And you won't lose any data that's not in the first cell if you use this method. Let's see what would happen if there was data in cells other than the first cell being merged. So let's undo. And let's place something in this cell. If we try to use the Center Across Selection option here, then these cells will appear normal, as though they hadn't been merged. One disadvantage with the Center Across Selection option is that it only works on horizontal data. So even though the Merge and Center command can merge these cells to make them appear like one cell, the Center Across Selection won't do that for vertical data. Now let's talk about those times when merging cells means combining the actual data that's in multiple cells into one cell. I'm going to show you two simple ways to do this, each with its own advantages. One is using the CONCAT function, and the second is by using the TEXTJOIN function. If we want to combine the values in these three cells to form a single string in this cell, we can enter equals, CONCAT, open parenthesis, and we can either enter each cell reference separated by commas, close parenthesis, Or we can type a cell range, close parenthesis, and our data has been merged. If we wanted to insert any additional text, we'd enclose them between double quotes. So if we wanted dashes between each element of the phone number, after the comma, we'd type a double quote, dash, double quote, comma, and do that each time we want to see that dash. And that's a really simple method of merging data from two or more cells into one cell. The second function is TEXTJOIN. This function has more arguments than CONCAT, but it's very useful, especially when you need to repeatedly insert the same text in between each cell value, like we just saw with our dashes. TEXTJOIN allows you to state that delimiter once, instead of having to type it in each time. So we type equals TEXTJOIN, open parenthesis, and our delimiter will be the dash. We type it in between double quotes and then a comma. The ignore empty argument tells Excel what to do if it comes across empty cells within the range. If we set it to true, Excel will skip the empty cells and move on to one with values. And if we set it to false, the delimiter for that empty cell is still returned. So you'd have consecutive delimiters with no values in between. We'll set ours to true and then our comma. And now we select our range, close parenthesis, and enter. That was pretty easy. So we've just learned two ways to merge data from multiple cells into one cell. Now let's change gears and learn how to split values in a single cell into two or more columns. These methods work if your data format is fairly uniform. So here, let's say we want to split these names so that the first names are in one column and the last names in another column. A very easy and fairly unknown method is flash fill, where you can teach Excel what you want your data to look like by entering the first two or three rows with the data in the format you want. So let's say we want this to say Jimmy Ramirez, Ann Cox. We can click in the last row where we entered values, then go to the Data tab and click the Flash Fill command. Go to the second column and repeat. And now our one column data has been split across two columns. Finally, we can use the left, mid, and right formulas to break up values in cells according to their position within the string. So for these phone numbers, we'll use the left function to extract the area code from column A. We type equals left, open parenthesis. Our text is located in cell A2. And the numchars argument is optional. It tells Excel how many characters to extract, counting from the left. If we leave this out, only a single character furthest to the left is returned. Of course, we want the first three numbers, so we type 3 and close parenthesis. And we double-click to fill to the remaining rows. Now we want the next three numbers. We use the mid function to extract them. Our text will be the value in A2. The next argument is where to start. We want to start with the fourth character, counting from the left. And the number of characters we want is 3. Close parenthesis and enter. Double click and it's filled. For the last four numbers, we use the right function. Our text is in A2, and the number of characters we want displayed counting from the right is 4. Close parenthesis, double click, and we're done. So you just learned two ways to format cells to have a merged appearance, two ways to merge data in cells, and two ways to split data across cells. I hope this was useful. Subscribe to our channel to get even more Excel tips.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.